I have to remind you again that what you're seeing was pre-recorded before that big battle royal Tuesday night in St. Paul, Minnesota, to crown the new world champion. Two men who were going into that battle supremely confident were Sergeant Slaughter and Colonel DeBeers. And let's get their comments.
The biggest prize that's ever been offered in a battle royal, that of the AWA World Heavyweight Championship. And when I win it, it's going back to Johannesburg, South Africa.
Then
they can come to me to get it.
That's right, baby. February 7th in St. Paul, Minneapolis. Be there, because this is going to be the victor, Colonel DeBeers.
Your champion, Colonel DeBeers.
You know, I've been in street fights, brawls, bar fights, alley fights. I've been in hand-to-hand combat, and I've been ambushed. Sometimes for nothing but my pride. Sometimes for my freedom, for your freedom, and sometimes for thousands of dollars. But February 7th, when I climb in that ring with all those other guys, 19 of them, I'm not taking any prisoners. I'm coming out, Sergeant Slaughter, as the AWA World Heavyweight Champion. Have I made myself clear? Good. Then you're dismissed.
Welcome to AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Larry Nelson, and joining me, the California Kid, Lee Marshall. And we've got a great one. We got the Battle Royal.
The Battle Royal, the first time in history that a champion is going to be crowned as the result of the Battle Royal. The last man to stand gets the greatest prize in sport, the AWA Heavyweight Championship of the World.
I picked the wrong man. I didn't get either one of the final two contestants. I picked Sergeant Slaughter, by the way. We'll hear from him. He does not win.
And I picked Colonel DeBeers. And the reason I picked him is I thought Diamond Dallas Page wanted to walk out of the St. Paul Civic with three championship belts. Bad Company is the tag champion, and DeBeers is the world champion. Didn't work out that way either.
So you know that it's not Colonel DeBeers, and you know that it's not Sergeant Slaughter. But first, before we do anything else, let's get comments from America's Hero.
Attention wrestling fans, Sergeant Slaughter here. Stay tuned and don't touch that dial. Keep that dial on ESPN and see all the greatest wrestlers from the AWA, including yours truly, Sergeant Slaughter. You know, I've had some real bad battles going on with Colonel DeBeers. Now, we had a big battle royal for the World Heavyweight Championship back in St. Paul, Minneapolis. And when I get done showing you this tape, you're going to see that Sergeant Slaughter got taken. I was in that battle royal. Everything was going my way. And all of a sudden, I got Colonel DeBeers where I wanted him, and I got him over the top rope. It was a joyous occasion. Everybody was very happy, including me. And when I looked down at Colonel DeBeers, he grabbed my arm, and his goofy manager grabbed my elbow. And the next thing I know, that scum, that slime, that maggot, that world champion, Larry Zbyszko, came up from behind me and threw me over the top rope. But that wasn't good enough for you, was it, DeBeers? You had to continue ramming my head into the mat, ramming my head into the ring post, slapping on my face. Well, let me tell you, Colonel DeBeers, when the time comes and I can get you in that ring, I hope it's right here on ESPN. Right here. So everybody in the world will be able to see me give you the whipping you deserve. And Larry Zbyszko, you're standing looking at the man right here that put your shoulders down 4 years ago. 1, 2, 3 for the America's Heavyweight Championship. I'm the only man that can stand here and tell you that I beat you 1, 2, 3. Not too many can do it. Larry Zbyszko, Colonel DeBeers, you're all getting close to a big beating. And when I get coming, you better start hiding. I may have made myself clear. Good, then you're dismissed, you maggots.
And in a few minutes, we're going to get to that battle royal. You'll be doing the play-by-play. I'll be introducing the wrestlers in the ring.
It's going to be something to see, fans, I guarantee it. One of the most historic moments in all of professional sport. The first time the greatest prize is ever going to be decided with a battle royal, the new heavyweight champion of the world, and you're going to get a look at who that is.
That's right after this, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere.
And there are some saying, from the nation of Japan, weighing 230 pounds, Akio, Sato. At 266 pounds, Wayne, the Train Bloom. From Boston, Massachusetts, one half Minnesota. At 258 pounds, the construction worker mean Mike Enos. From San Diego, California, at 240 pounds, Tommy Jammer. One half of the tag team champions of the world, from Honolulu, Hawaii, Pat Tanaka. From Phoenix, Arizona, weighing in at 237 pounds, Tom Zenk. One half of the tag team champions of the world. From Canada, he is Paul Diamond. From Mound, Minnesota, the international television champion of the world, 218 pounds, Greg Gagne. From Portland, Oregon, at 268 pounds, Olympic strongman, Ken Patera. From Edina, Minnesota, one half of the top guns, he is Ricky Rice. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 247 pounds, living legend, Larry Zbyszko. From the University of Oklahoma, at 270 pounds, Chief Wahoo McDaniel. From El Paso, Texas, at 277 pounds, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. From Paris Island, South Carolina, at 303 pounds, America's hero, Sergeant Slaughter. And from the Republic of South Africa, at 267 pounds, the mercenary Colonel DeBeers. One of these men will be the heavyweight champion of the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned. Right after this, you're going to have the opportunity to see one of the most historic events in all of history as the AWA Champion of the World is going to be crowned as a result of this upcoming Battle Royal. Don't you dare go away.
Lee Marshall and Ray Stevens and fans, there has never been anything like this in the world. All these men in the ring at one time, whoever is the last to go out will be the new heavyweight champion of the world. And I know, Ray, you wanted more than anything to probably be in there tonight with these men. An opportunity to have the greatest prize in all of sport, the AWA Championship of the World.
Well, that's what it's all about, and this is the first time in the history of wrestling that they've ever had a battle royal to determine the winner of going to be the world champion. And the reason for that is because they stripped Jerry Lawler of the title.
That's right.
I think that he wasn't showing up in his matches. Maybe he had a big yellow streak down his back with some of the opponents that he had or something.
Well, if you look in the ring, I'm not saying I blame him, but my goodness, you look at the caliber of athlete that's in the ring tonight. We saw something interesting. You talk about two strong men going at it. Power lifter Wayne the Train Bloom and power lifter par excellence Ken Patera. They were going at it. There's Sergeant Slaughter. You've got Tom Zenk, Wahoo McDaniel, Tommy Jammer, Mean Mike Enos, Steve Ray, Greg Gagne, Larry Zbyszko, Manny Fernandez, Colonel DeBeers. And there's the old rivalry heating up right away. Sergeant Slaughter and Colonel DeBeers. Ringside, that's Ricky Rice along with Wayne the Train Bloom, and down goes Rice. There's Diamond Dallas Page. He's got three men in the ring, the tag team champions of the world, and Colonel DeBeers. And knowing Diamond Dallas Page, I think he would love nothing better to walk out of here tonight with the tag champs and the heavyweight champion of the world.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. That would be great for him. But I'll tell you what, there's not a guy in there that's not capable. They're all capable of winning the championship.
That's while they're in there. Gagne unloading on the sensei, Pat Tanaka. Mean Mike Enos working on Wahoo McDaniel, and look who's got a hold of Wahoo. Who else? A raging bull, Manny Fernandez, finding that elbow into the forehead of Wahoo. Sergeant Slaughter and Colonel DeBeers going at it. Greg Gagne pulls DeBeers off of the sergeant. Boom! Big right hand by Sergeant Slaughter. Paul Diamond, half a bad company, the tag team champions of the world in the thick of things. Derrick Starfire Dukes now unloading on Mean Mike Enos. Mike George in there, he's doing some damage to the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. It's like a who's who of professional wrestling, Larry. Every name that we mentioned, as you said, all of them caliber, top caliber. There's Gagne. Greg Gagne almost went out. Headbutt. Had Tanaka leveling Derrick Starfire Dukes. Ken Patera coming over, giving Tanaka a little taste of some bad medicine for bad company. That's Mike George and Larry Zbyszko. Sergeant Slaughter working on Wayne the Train Bloom. Boom! Tom Zenk unloading on Paul Diamond. Wow!
It's going to be amazing if somebody doesn't come out of this hurt very bad.
Oh, so God.
There's a bunch of mean people in this ring at the same time here. A lot of beef.
Oh, yeah. We've seen battle royals for $10,000, $25,000, even $50,000. This is the first time a battle royal will result in the greatest prize in all of sport, the heavyweight championship of the world. And you've got to know, Ray, every man in there is hungry for that championship belt. Every man in there has had a dream about being the champion of the world.
Oh, absolutely. And they know this is for all the marbles, and they're trying twice as hard. Did somebody get hit over the top rope?
Looks like Tommy Jammer went over the top rope. Tommy Jammer is, in fact, out. Larry Zbyszko working on Derrick Dukes. Bang! Right hand by the living legend into the midsection of Derrick Dukes. Tanaka and Gagne going at it. Headbutt by Tanaka. Another headbutt and Gagne's reeling.
You know, I've been watching here at the bull, Manny Fernandez. Every time he gets a chance, he's sucker punching Wahoo McDaniels and then weaving.
Oh, I know it. I'm also not that surprised by it. Tom Zenk's got Paul Diamond. Ricky Rice is out. Akio Sato with a rake of the eyes. That's Steve Ray. He's working over Paul Diamond. Oh, well, I'm surprised at that. That's Mean Mike Enos.
Big man to go over that top rope and hit that concrete.
Took more than one guy to throw Mean Mike Enos out of the top rope, I guarantee you.
You know, these battles.
Manny Fernandez working on Gagne headbutt. Another one. Oh, man, he's going to open him up like a can. Manny Fernandez is all over Greg
Gagne.
Gee whiz.
Tom Zenk almost out here.
Who's got him? Is that Zbyszko?
There's Zbyszko.
There's Wayne the Train Bloom. Bloom is gone.
Wow.
The handwork of Ken Patera. These two guys were going at it. I mean, they had a point to prove to each other as to who was the greatest weightlifter. And without a doubt, America is so proud of the accomplishments of Ken Patera. Down goes the raging bull, Manny Fernandez. Oh, this is absolute mayhem in the ring tonight.
Absolutely. I tell you, you're looking at a bunch of the best there is here right now, and they're going for all the marbles.
I'll tell
the
you,
World Championship.
Zenk and Zbyszko, they're just flat out going to each other. Gagne off the top rope, right into the face of Manny, the raging bull Fernandez. Colonel DeBeers now, he's got Derrick Dukes. Halfway out, Tom Zenk. Colonel DeBeers has got. Man, what a clothesline by the living legend, Larry Zbyszko, and he sent Steve Ray for the big ride. Ray pulls Zbyszko out. That's not going to get it, though, fans.
I believe that is Mike George.
Is that George? Well, there's Tom Zenk right now working on Zbyszko. You're right. That was Mike George. That's Patera out, but you got to go over the top rope. So when they pulled Zbyszko out through the ropes, that didn't get it. And now look at this. You talk about friendships put aside. That's Gagne and Sergeant Slaughter.
You can't have friends in here.
No way. Ken Patera eliminated. The Olympic strongman. He's out of this battle royal. Wahoo McDaniel is down. Look at Slaughter. Slaughter's got Gagne. He's going to put Gagne out. Zink's got a hold of Manny Fernandez right in front of Diamond Dallas Page. Boom! Fernandez into the turnbuckle. Oh, man. And still Slaughter and Gagne going at it. Larry Zbyszko and Colonel DeBeers. They're also going at it. That's Paul Diamond working over Wahoo McDaniel. Gee.
Colonel DeBeers, Colonel DeBeers, very close to putting the Sarge out. Meanwhile, it's Larry Zbyszko working on Greg Gagne. Sarge just about out. Pat Tanaka with a series of tremendous chops. Sergeant Slaughter, I don't know if he can hold on. That's Tanaka working on Wahoo. Wahoo's got both members of Bad Company. Noggin knocker.
There's so much going on, it's awful hard to keep track of everything here.
But now it's Tanaka and Manny Fernandez both working over Wahoo McDaniel. Like you said, Ray, there are no friends. What happens if it boils down to Tanaka and Diamond?
I noticed that Manny Fernandez is, every time he gets a chance, so he's coming up and putting a hurt on McDaniels and then leaving.
And now Greg Gagne's got to deal with the raging bull, Manny Fernandez. I'll tell you, the guys in here are taking turns on the international television champion, but nobody can put him out. Gagne's still in there. Tom Zenk working on Mike George. And it's Colonel DeBeers and Sergeant Slaughter. Slaughter ramming DeBeers' head right into the turnbuckle. Akio Sato over the top rope. Diamond Dallas Page has got a hold of Derrick Dukes. That's Wahoo McDaniel. McDaniel is out.
Manny Fernandez put him out.
Oh, Manny's got to love that. Got to love that. Tanaka locked up now with the living legend Larry Zbyszko. Mike George and Tom Zenk. Manny Fernandez is gone. Mike George just thrown over the top rope by Tom Zenk. You got Pat Tanaka, Greg Gagne, Tom Zenk, Sergeant Slaughter, Larry, the living legend Zbyszko, and Colonel DeBeers left in the ring. Zenk and Zbyszko going to square up. DeBeers still trying to put Sergeant Slaughter out. It's Tanaka and Greg Gagne. Six men left in the ring. Zbyszko working over Tom Zenk. Gagne now with a right hand. On the sensei, Pat Tanaka, he rams Tanaka into the turnbuckle. Zbyszko likewise does the same to Tom Zenk, followed by a big right hand. And I'll tell you, Slaughter and DeBeers, they are going at it full throttle. Now it's Sergeant Slaughter trying to put Colonel DeBeers, the mercenary from South Africa, out. Gagne misses. He went for a high-risk move on Tanaka. Tanaka rolled out of the way. I think Gagne's hurt. If he wasn't, he is now. Did you see that boot by Colonel DeBeers? He ignores Gagne. He wants another piece of Sergeant Slaughter. There's Zbyszko and Tom Zenk.
Zbyszko's in trouble right now.
He is. Here comes DeBeers. Oh, what a vicious headbutt by Tanaka into Greg Gagne. Now DeBeers has got Tom Zenk. Slaughter locks it up now with Pat Tanaka. And you've got Larry Zbyszko and Greg Gagne. Zbyszko and Gagne. Slaughter and Tanaka. DeBeers and Tom Zenk. Tanaka into the turnbuckle head first. Zbyszko's got a hold of Greg Gagne. He's gone. Gagne is gone. Oh, man, did Zbyszko dump Gagne. In the ring now, Sergeant Slaughter, Colonel DeBeers, the sensei, Pat Tanaka, Larry Zbyszko, and Tom Zenk. Headbutt by the sensei, Pat Tanaka. Clubbing right hand by Larry Zbyszko. It's Tanaka and the Sarge. Right hand by Tanaka into the side of the face of Sergeant Slaughter. Tanaka misses. He's gone. He's gone. Slaughter takes Tanaka out. Now Zabisco's got Slaughter. In the meantime, Tom Zenk in there with Colonel DeBeers. DeBeers, he put Zenk through the second rope. I'm not sure that Zenk went over the top. I don't think so. I haven't heard an official word yet. Zenk might be out. I'm not sure. In the meantime, Larry, the living legend Zbyszko, Colonel DeBeers, G.I. Joe, America's hero, Sergeant Slaughter. What a heads-up move by the Sarge. Oh, he almost got DeBeers. He got him that time. DeBeers is out.
Uh-oh, Zbyszko.
And now it's Colonel. You're right. Zenk was not eliminated. Zbyszko put Slaughter out. Zbyszko thinks he's won it. He's still got to deal with Tom Zenk. It's Tom Zenk and Larry Zbyszko. Tom Zenk and Larry Zbyszko. Derusha for the count, only a two. As you heard Larry Nelson say, Slaughter's eliminated. Vertical suplex by Tom Zenk. The last man to stand is the heavyweight champion of the world. It will be either the living legend Larry Zbyszko or Tom Zenk from Phoenix, Arizona. Atomic drop by Zenk, and down goes Zbyszko. The cover, two, kick out by Zbyszko. Oh, man.
Boy, I'm telling you, Zink's taking it right to him right now, and they're both tired. You know they got to be tired. Oh, what a body slam.
Oh, man. count of two. Just got the count of two. Off the ropes comes Zenk.
Oh! Right there shows you, you can never blink your eye when you're in there with an experienced veteran like everybody in this Battle Royal. This Battle Royal has been fantastic.
I'm telling you, it's been a Hall of Fame match from top to bottom. When the whistle blows, everybody goes, and they sure have right from the beginning of this match, and it's boiled down to this, fans, Tom Zenk and Larry Zbyszko. There's Bill After, senior editor of Pro Wrestling Illustrated. Of course, he's here chronicling this historic event. Two clubbing right forearms by Larry Zbyszko. And now Zenk's in trouble. Zbyszko's got him up for the slam. Boom! Down for the cover goes Zbyszko. Two kick out by Zenk. Whoa! Boy, both Zenk and Zbyszko have gone to a couple of two counts already. And they've got the right man in there with Gary DeRuscia. He's your third man in the ring, Zbyszko, for the cover. He's on his toes, kicked out by Zenk. Whoa, man!
You can see this is taking its toll on both of these men.
It sure has. Look at Tom Zenk, just gasping for air. And I guarantee you, Zbyszko's not a lot better off. Pile driver! Oh, man! Zbyszko for the cover. He thinks he's got him. Go!
Put over the rope. Put over the rope.
Zbyszko can't believe it. He can't believe it. Zbyszko having words with Gary DeRuscia to the right of your screen. That's Bill After. What a great man. I'm so proud of him for being here covering this great event. Right hand by Zenk. Right foot into the midsection of the living legend. Into the ropes goes Zbyszko. Here comes Zenk. Nobody home. Whoa. What a break for Zbyszko.
Tell you what they're going after. This has turned into a tremendous match. The last two men in this battle royal. Zenk again saved himself. Good thinking on Zenk's part.
What?
Zbyszko can't believe it. The living legend all over. Tom Zenk. Reversal by Zenk. Oh, face first goes Zbyszko. I'll tell you, Zenk's needle might be on empty. This would have been a great opportunity for him to cover Zbyszko.
Well, after what they've been through, you can't expect everything out of them right now. I'll tell you what, they're going on pure instinct and guts right now.
I'm telling you something else, fans. You're not going to see action like this anywhere else but the AWA. You want the real deal.
You come to the right place. Oh, no, Zbyszko
right into Gary DeRuscia. DeRuscia's out of the ring. Got kicked by Zenk. Zbyszko's down. Zenk's got him.
He's got him.
He's got him. I don't even see Gary DeRuscia. There he is. There's DeRuscia. One, two,
three. Oh, he lifted that left, right, left shoulder up. He's just doing it on pure instinct, Lee.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I thought for sure Tom Zenk was the new heavyweight champion of the world, and he might well be now that Gary DeRuscia's back in the ring. Because Zbyszko is rocked.
Oh, what a suplex.
Whoa, he nailed him with all of it. Zbyszko could be done for right here. Zenk's got to cover him. One, two,
three. I'm going to tell you what, Zbyszko's saving his energy. He's just lifting that shoulder. He's not trying to kick out of there.
I don't know where he's getting the energy, but that's all he's got to do is get one shoulder up. Zbyszko's managed to do it twice so far. Into the ropes goes Tom Zenk. Shoulder tackle by Zenk, and down goes Zbyszko. Vertical bow! Zenk's right over the top rope.
Right there is your winner over the top rope.
That's it. DeRuscia's calling for the bell.
That's your winner.
You're absolutely right. Zenk over the top rope. The new heavyweight champion of the world. The living legend from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Larry Zbyszko.
I tell you.
Oh, man. Counsel for the AWA, Bob Ryan. He's got the championship belt. And now Zbyszko telling everybody in the world what he is.
Presenting the heavyweight championship belt to Larry Zbyszko. On behalf of AWA, President Stanley Blackburn is Bob Ryan. Ladies and gentlemen, the heavyweight champion of the world.
I tell you,
I mean, you're just really glad to see this, aren't you?
No comment. The heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko.
I'll tell you, Larry Zbyszko has just about done it all, and now he can say that he has, Ray, the heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, I told you earlier in the battle royal, A lot of luck goes along with it, and I'm going to tell you, Larry Zbyszko was very, very lucky to get Tom Zenk over that top rope because he didn't know where he was at the time.
Here's the champion.
If you said people like it or not, okay? In 14 glorious years, Foothead, nobody can beat me. Nobody has beat me. Just to use that to get to try to outsmart the Fox in his own game.
Wow,
ladies and gentlemen, once again, the heavyweight champion of the world,
the grandest prize in all of professional sport, Larry Zbyszko. He's called himself the living legend. He said, I'm the guy that put San Martino out. I'm the guy that put Bockwinkel out. And here it comes, vertical press. But look at Zbyszko. He just rolls Zenk out, and that's all. Over the top rope, as we said, the last man in walks away with the gold.
And so there it is, ladies and gentlemen, for better or for worse, and certainly by the grace of a referee that was not silly, Larry Zbyszko is now the heavyweight champion of the world, coming out on top in this magnificent battle royal. Immediately following that match, Bill After was standing by, and he got words from the new heavyweight champion of the world.
Hello, everyone. This is Bill After from Pro Wrestling Illustrated Magazine. Just got done the battle royal to determine a new AWA champion. I just photographed the match. Larry Zbyszko beating out Tom Zenk at the end. The champ's working his way toward our interview area. Larry Zbyszko, congratulations.
Why did you step back in the ring? Boy.
Larry, 14 years you've been after a world title. You finally realized your dream. AWA heavyweight champion. You know, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you. I knew this 14 glorious years ago. You know, when I first met Bruno Sammartino, the very first day we trained together, I knew I was as great or greater than that man, okay? You know what my secret is? I am a product of all the best professional wrestlers that ever were and that ever will be. I was trained by Bruno, by Strongbow. I could name names of people that you don't even know. They're the ones that made me a champion.
What about the and people you know now what? That are going to try?
Let me tell you something.
That?
I'm not done with my story yet. I'm you know it, and I want it written. You know, I've overcome since I began as Rookie of the Year, and the man that I trusted the most in my career stabbed me in the back. Yeah, you know what happened ever since then? Ever since I retired San Martino, people have been running from me from one promotional group to another federation to another association, but the cream just can't help but rise to the top. I could not help become the heavyweight champion of the world because it was my destiny. I had no choice. Okay?
Wait a second. Tom Zenk is out there, wants to know if he's going to get a rematch, get a shot against you because he was the last man in with you.
Well, I mentioned some other champions that have ran for me. Ric Flair just spent a whole year running from me. Okay? I'm not a kind of champion like I wasn't a man all the rest of my life that's going to run from somebody. You know, I fly planes through thunderstorms, my own. I look death in the face. And I spit in its eye. I'm like a generation that you don't find anymore. Nowadays, you wimpy society of robotized sheep. All you care about is how white your teeth are, what color your hair is. But you don't know what the hard way is anymore. You don't become a world champion by looking good, by putting makeup on your face, or sticking your tongue out during an interview. You become the champion because you're the best wrestler in the entire world. Now, all the federations can make all the claims they want from this day forward, but the reality of the matter is, there's no other champion that can beat me. If you can, my challenge's open. Flair, the other one, anytime, any place. If you don't meet me, you're the coward. But to all the federations, you can save all the hype, because Larry Zbyszko, I, after 14 glorious years, am the Major League of Professional Wrestling.
With an exclusive interview right after his victory in the Battle Royal to determine a new AWA champion, this is Bill After from Pro Wrestling Illustrated. We'll see you at the matches. Magazine Bill After, a great, fantastic Battle Royal to determine an AWA heavyweight champion. The last two guys left in the ring, Tom Zenk and Larry Zbyszko. Tom, you went at Zbyszko at the end with a flying body press, and he catapulted you over the ropes all over. What's your reaction?
Well, naturally, Bill, I'm very disappointed because I've been training hard, and I've been out of wrestling in the United States for a little bit since I left the WWF, and I came back and really been training hard for this, and Zbyszko's back in the AWA now, and I guess he caught me off guard. It was a real smart move, and I guess I have to give credit where credit's due, but believe me, that's not a singles match. And after the battle royal, you're wore down, and it just didn't work, Bill, like I thought it would.
Okay, Tom Zenk, thank you very much. And now, right now, let's go to Larry Nelson.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've heard Bill Apter talk about it. We've heard Larry Zbyszko discuss it. Tom Zenk gave us his comments. Now let's ask the man, the champ. What about this title match? First time in history for a battle royal to decide a heavyweight championship.
Well, it really is, and it's a historic event, really, because it's a very unusual way to determine who the world champion is in the league. Of course, with Larry Zbyszko winning it, I think it was rather a shock to everybody. I'm a little bit prejudiced. I was hoping my son would win the thing, and he was too, and he had really trained hard for this, and as is everyone in that battle royal did. But we got down to Tom Zenk and Larry Zbyszko. And I thought Tom Zenk was going to win it there because he did have him down for about a 10 or 11, 12 count, whatever it was. And the referee, of course, knocked out of the ring and was not able to get that count in there. But that's just the breaks of the game. We've all had them. I know I've had some of the title matches that I had over the years very disappointing at times. But that's just the way it happens. I'm sure it's very disappointing for a young Tom Zenk. He's got great years ahead of him. He certainly arrived as a wrestler, and Larry Zbyszko has got one tough opponent in that young man, and he'll be right on his tail, plus about 50 other guys that want to crack at Larry Zbyszko.
The competition's strenuous for the new heavyweight champion. Correctly. Speaking of world champions, ladies and gentlemen, the big battle royal in St. Paul, Minnesota, determined that Larry Zbyszko now reigns atop the wrestling world.
You know, speaking of reigning, a year ago, we had a bet. I win the heavyweight championship of the world, and you were going to shave off your beard. What about it?
Oh, come on. Now, that was a long
time ago. A bet's a bet.
A long time ago, completely
different. You're not a man of your word, are you, Nelson?
I'm a man of my word.
You just like the championship committee.
It's a different time and a different circumstance, and you know it.
You know, this guy Roy Firestone's been calling me on ESPN, wants me to come down and do an interview. And I'm going to come out here and say, same thing I tell Roy or anybody else, I am the heavyweight champion of the world. Worldwide. There's a couple other people claim to be champions. All they've done for me is run. So you know what? I'm challenging everybody. If you call yourself a champion, wrestle me. If you don't, call the AWA and work your way up to be a contender. Because I am the heavyweight champion of the world, and I am the major league of professional wrestling.
Larry Zbyszko, ladies and gentlemen, one thing's for sure, he's got confidence.